Me too. Connected.
Y'all ready for some music?
Is the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Told the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. The blazing Yule before us. Strike the harp and join the chorus. Follow me in merry measure while I tell of Yuletide treasure. Follow la 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 la.
Snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
price, right? Here it is.
The Angel Gabriel is Nazareth, a town in Galilee. The virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said,
"Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you."
Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail.
I am the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled."
That the mother of my Lord should come to me. For behold, when the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord.
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation.
And Mary remained with her for about 3 months and returned to her home. Of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said,
"Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel." Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, from the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth, but there was no place for them in the inn.
5 miles on a donkey for having to walk 85 miles. That's where they had to go, where they were, to where Jesus was being born. 85 miles.
Over there, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, great company of the heavenly host appeared to the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
They saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. You have heard the story of Jesus' birth and have seen it brought to life by actors, animals, and narration. But why is this Jesus so important? This child who changed history is the Son of God. He came to take away the sins of those who put their faith in him. The Bible tells us that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We have all disobeyed God's law at some point in our lives. The Bible also tells us that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Only through Jesus' death on the cross and resurrection from the grave can we get rid of that sin so that we can live in heaven with our perfect God. Though this forgiveness of sin is free, it isn't automatic. The Bible says that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Have you done this yourself? Have you prayed and told Jesus that you know you are a sinner and that you need forgiveness? Have you asked him to forgive your sins? Do you believe in him? If you have not made this decision, what is keeping you from doing so tonight? In a moment, you will be given a gift, and you will see some counselors who are standing by to help you make that decision, to pray with you, or to answer any questions you may have. We hope you have enjoyed your journey tonight. We pray you will remember the reason for the season. Have a very Merry Christmas.